Yes, exercise 4.3, question number 6. In question number 6, if the work done by the body on application of a constant force is directly proportional to the distance traveled by the body, means work done jo hai, that is directly proportional to the distance traveled by the body. Iska kya meaning hai? Suppose the work done be y, let work done is y and distance covered is x. So work done is directly proportional to the distance covered. This thing is given in the question. Now work done is y. When you remove this proportionality sign, it will be equal k times the distance covered, that is x. Is it okay? Work done is directly proportional to the distance. Distance we have taken as x. Directly proportional will change to equal to, and constant k will be introduced. Now the here, this k is your constant force. Some work done will be there. If you insert some force on the thing, then only the distance will be covered. So here the constant force is given as force is 5 units, that is given in the question. So your equation become y is equal to 5x. This constant force has been changed to 5 because it has been given in the question. So your equation is y is equal to 5x. Now what you have to do is you have to make the graph of this, and for the graph you need at least 3 solutions. So I have written x, y. If I put x 0, y will be 1, y will be 0. If I put x 1, y will be 5. 2, it will be n. So on the x-axis, you will take the value 0, 1, 2, and on y-axis, you will take the values as 0, 5, 10, 15, and so on. Now let's plot the graph. You can draw complete Cartesian plane, or you can just simply draw the first axis, first quadrant, because values are positive. So it will work if you take this. This is your x, this is your y. On y-axis, you will take 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. Okay. And here 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So this is your, what you have taken here, this is your, x is your distance and y is your work done. Okay. So let's plot the graph. First value is this. Second is x 1, y 5, x 2, 5. So this will be your graph. Scale you will write here. For x axis, you have scale of 1 box is equal to 1. Distance covered. Distance covered is in, nothing is given, so it will be units, 1 unit. And for the y axis, the distance work done is 5. Okay. Now you have to answer the question. First question is, if the distance traveled by the body is 2, then what will be the, read from the graph the work done when the distance traveled by the body is 2. When the distance traveled is 2, then the work done will be 10. So first part answer is 10. Second part is 10 units. Actually, unit is not given, so you will write unit. Now, the second part is, when the distance traveled is x, then what will be the work done? That will be 0. Okay, so you have to give answer from the graph, not from that equation. So you have to join this. This will give you first value, this will give you second value. Any doubt? एनी डाउट बेटा? आफ्टर डूइंग दिस स्टार्ट रीडिंग द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एंड टेल मी द इक्वेशन फॉर्म. डू इट, हरी अप. Have you noticed one thing that in this graph we have taken different scale on both the axes? So you can take different values and different scale on both the axes. It doesn't make any difference because it's not possible for us to take 1, 2, 3, 4 on y-axis. So same thing that we have used here, different scale that we will also use in the next question, because in next question you have big values. So if you try to take 1, 2, 3, it's not possible. So you have to take large values and different scale on both the axes. Done. Done. Okay. Next question is, two girls are there, Fatima and Yamini. These are the two students of class 9 and they are willing to contribute to the Prime Minister Relief Fund, and for that in total they are giving 100 rupees. We don't know the contribution of each person separately, but we know their combined contribution. That is, let contribution of both B, X and Y, rupees X and rupees Y. If you want to change the language, you can. You can write it at your own. So both the girls are contributing 100 rupees in total. So X plus Y will give you 100. Now what's next? You have to form the graph of this, and for the graph you need at least 3 different values. So make the table. X, Y. Yes, listen one thing. If I put 1 here, 0 here, it will give you Y as 100. If you put 1 here, it will give you 99. So 99 is such a big value. So you will take the value, 100 is given, so you will take 20, 30, 40 as a value of X. You will not start with 0, okay? So start from the middle one. If you take X is equal to 40, Y is equal to 60. If you take X 50, Y 50. If you take X 60, Y will be 40. So your values are 40, 50, 60 for both X and Y. Hope it is clear to you all. So let's make the graph of this, and for the graph again the values are positive, so both X and Y have positive value, so you will not take negative X's, you will take only positive X's. X axis, Y axis, on this X has positive value, on this Y is having positive value, and here this is the contribution of Jamini and this is Y is representing the contribution of Fatima. Okay, Fatima and Yamini are the two girls. So you will write Yamini's contribution and here Fatima's contribution. Okay, now you will take, you can start from 40, 50, 60 as well, or you can take 10, 20, 30. It's depend upon you. If you will start from 40, then you will put kink here. So it is as per your wish. You can take 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. If you want to take 40 in the beginning, so you will put kink here in on y-axis also. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay. X 40, Y 60. X 50, Y 50. X 60, Y 40. So this represents your equation X plus Y is equal to 100. Okay, now let's write the scale. On x-axis, you have taken rupees 10. On y-axis also, you have gap of rupees 10. Is it clear? Any doubt? But that question we have left in the earlier chapter, leave it because it include the area of trapezium. Did you remember about the area of Heron's formula? In that we have left the question number three of exercise 12.2. Leave it because it includes the area of quadrilateral that is not in the syllabus. So leave that question, and the remaining things we have already discussed, you will do that only. Phone se net leke kar liya. Haan, net ki problem. Anything which is not clear, tomorrow you have test of exercise 7.3 and 7.4. Test is at 2 p.m. So get ready for your test. It's compulsory to give the test. Anything which is not clear from this question? Now let's start with the next question. The next question, you have 4-5 parts. So you have to make the graph also. So let's start with question number 8. In question number 8, beta, you have given the relation between Fahrenheit is equal to 9/5 C plus 32. This is your equation for changing Fahrenheit to Celsius or Celsius to Fahrenheit. Now you have to make the graph of this. What you will do, you will take this Fahrenheit represent your y coordinate. This C Celsius represent your x coordinate. This is given in the question, but still if it is not given, you can take it at your own. Now you will form the table of this thing. Again, I'm solving it verbally, but if you want, you can solve by writing also. If I put C is equal to 0, then this complete thing will be 0. Fahrenheit is 32. If I put C as 10, if I put C as 5 first, 5 will cancel out, this will be your 41. So if I put 5 here, you will be getting 41. If I put C as 10 plus 32, 9 twos are 18 plus 32, that is 50. Okay. So these three different values we are getting. Now you will plot these on the graph and you have to answer the following question that are given. Now, let's plot the graph. Five, 10, 15, 20. This is your Celsius. Celsius you are taking here. And here you will take Fahrenheit. Okay. Now, for the Fahrenheit, you have 32, maximum 50. You can start from 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay, if you want to take 10, 20, 30, you can. Now, the first value is C. If C is 0, F is 32. If C is 5, F is 41. If C is 10, then this will be 40. Is it okay? So this is the graph. Now, you have to answer the question. What's the scale? This is 5 degrees Celsius and for this we have taken 10 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, answer the following question. This is your Y, this is your X. It's compulsory to mention the X. First question we had done. Second is, if the temperature is 30 degree, then what will be the temperature in Fahrenheit? Increase this line. Okay, check the answer from this. You will definitely get the correct answer on your graph because I am constructing it on board, so I'm not sure about the answer. You please tell me. You can check the answer from here also. If I write 30 here, 5 will cancel out with 30, it will be 6. 9, 6 are 54. 54 plus 32, that will be 86 degree. 86 degree. So the answer of your second part is 86 degree Fahrenheit. Second part is, if the temperature is 95 degree Fahrenheit, ye aapke paas 70, 80, 90, 100. Agar aapke paas temperature 95 hai, so you have to give the answer. Increase this line further and join it here and tell me the answer. Okay? And now you can check the answer from here also. Actually, whenever it is written that you have to answer from the graph, you can't solve it. It is for your satisfaction. You can check the answer at the rough part. But you will not show that. If you take 95 here, it will be 9/5, C plus 32. You can't take 9/5 here. 95 minus 32 is equal to 9/5 C. Subtract it, you will get 63. This 5 will multiply and 9 will come here, C will 35 degree. Answer will be 35 degree Celsius. Third part is, in the third part, you have given the temperature is 0 degree Celsius. What is the temperature of Fahrenheit? Agar 0 degree hai, toh ye kitna aa raha hai? Ye kitna aa raha hai? 32. So iska answer yehi hai. And if Fahrenheit is 0, then what will be the Celsius? If Fahrenheit is 0, if your Fahrenheit will become 0, this 0, then what will be the value? Now, can you tell me how you will show that? Aap kya karoge? Ye dekho, iski jagah 0 likhoge. 9/5 C plus 32, this 32 will be there. You will shift it on that next side. Minus 32 into 5 upon 9. So you will get the answer in decimal. 10, 15, 16 upon 9. Minus 160 upon 9. And in the fourth part we will discuss tomorrow. It will take time and the time is already over. So we will discuss the next part in the next class.